Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. I just came from the gym, so I'm super out of breath. So bear with me. If you don't know me, I'm Game from BusyWorksBeats.com. We've trained over 800,000 producers around the world. Some have gone to work with Drake, Kanye West, Post Malone, Ariana Grande, French Montana, Ray Shrem, and YG, Young Thug. Did I say Post Malone already? I probably did. NBA Youngboy, Trippie Redd, J. Cole, and the list goes on and on and on. As far as Billboard charting artists. So shout out to you guys for being successful. I want to introduce you guys to Web 3.0 and make it extremely simple because there's so many videos out there and I've looked them up myself about music, NFTs, and just NFTs in general. And it's still confusing because people are talking on like, you know, university high level and we're kindergartners. So I'm going to make this video extremely simple to understand, extremely easy to understand and make it extremely simple for you. And we're going to grow in this process because Web 3.0 is still being developed. And I think a lot of people don't tell you that. So it creates a lot of confusion. There are certain things that we expect to happen that aren't there yet. So people have a lot of optimism for this Web 3, but they don't tell you why. And that's why there's a missing gap in the importance of NFT. So firstly, I'm going to go through myths. I have some notes here. I'm going to check my notes. I even got lighting for you guys so you can see me properly, even though I probably put the lighting in the wrong place. But we're going to go over a couple myths that you hear about NFTs because, and my battery's on 5%, so I got to be quick, is that you're hearing a lot of myths and that's what's confusing you about NFTs. Always remember, confusion is the son of the devil, the devil. Okay, so anytime you're confused, always remember that that's not a good thing. Chaos, we want to take chaos into order. Okay, so without further ado, here's one huge myth that people talk about when it comes to NFTs, and that's that you have to sell your copyrights with your NFT. That's not the case. You do not have to sell your copyrights to your songs as if, like, most people think of it like, okay, if I make an NFT and it's a beat or it's a song, I no longer have rights to it and I'm selling it exclusively and to the highest bidder. That's not how this thing works. Maybe for the art world, it works that way in some degrees, but for this music industry, it doesn't have to work that way. So NFTs does not automatically mean that somebody who buys your song has ownership, or excuse me, copyrights to your music, okay? So that's something that's up to you if you wanna offer that in your package, if that's something that your people will value. But you don't have to offer that because that's a big myth that I hear. It's more so, NFTs are more so about owning things. So for example, the easiest kind of explanation I can think about with owning something is if you've ever gone to a sports game and you see that guy outside the stadium who's what is it called? Scalping tickets or whatever. He has those fake tickets and he's trying to sell you fake tickets to get into the game. And then you get up to the front door and you're like, hey, here's my ticket. I bought it at 50% discount from this guy out front because he was selling his ticket. And I tried to get in the game and they're like, this is fake. You just wasted your money. This is not a real ticket. So what NFTs allow you to do is prove that you actually have the real thing. Now, what does that mean in the music world? Okay, I can prove that I own the J. Cole song. That's not the point. The cool part about NFTs is how you build your business around people holding your thing. And this is the cool part that musicians and artists never really had. So I'm giving you like a broad spectrum so you can really understand the value of NFT. Because for the first time, NFTs are allowing people to have a membership program with their artistry and their music. It's allowing people to have an affiliate program with their artistry and their music. It's allowing people to reward people who have, supported them along their way with airdrops and different things. This is the first time it was made easy to do this without a bunch of tech and a bunch of centralized programs that make it extremely hard to code and all that type of stuff. So that's what it opens up for the average musician. Before, you've never really understood memberships. Now, us internet folks, I consider myself an internet marketer. I was trained by Frank Kern under Dan Kennedy and all the OG internet marketers. So we understood that to a degree, having memberships, subscription, recurring revenue, understanding your audience, how to deliver value over time instead of just one-off products. We've been doing this since 2014, 16, but the majority of the music industry was behind. And this is what this Web 3.0 is giving you. So NFTs are not only giving you the ability to sell something at a price, it's allowing you to offer people things and access that they wouldn't have had before. Okay, so that's the cool part. And they have to actually hold the NFT to have access to whatever it is you offer. So for example, if it's you, let's say you're an artist and you throw private concerts every quarter, every 3 months, you have a private concert for anybody who holds your NFT. Think of an NFT like a key. If they hold your key, then they can get into the private party every 3 months. Now, if they sell that key to somebody else, not only will, my webcam's gone out of focus. Hold on, y'all. Okay. No, hold up. Okay, not only will you get royalties for somebody selling that key to someone else, because you'll get a certain percentage if you set it up that way. So let's make it easy. Okay, I have something, it's an album, it's a song, and I sell the NFT for $100. Now the NFT, my phone is running out of battery, so I gotta put it on battery preserving mode before this thing runs out of battery. Hold on, y'all. Real life, no edits. Okay, here we go. Now the screen's gonna probably turn off, but the point is, I sell you something, a song for $100 or an album for $100. It's not just an exclusive album. It's also access to those quarterly concerts. But the problem is, if you buy it for $100 and then sell it to your friend for $300, I will get a percent, the creator of the album or the song will get a cut of that trade. So if I sell it to you for $100, I get $100. Great. Now you sell it to your friend for $200. I also get a cut of the $200. It's an immutable, meaning unchangeable, contract on the blockchain in which you use. Okay, so that's the cool part, is that it's royalties that you were never given in the traditional sense when somebody passes ownership to another person. For example, if I sold you my headphones, the company doesn't make money every time it gets resold. It's a secondary market, but the owner of the person who created the thing never gets royalties on that. So for the first time, you're gonna get royalties for selling something, and then that person sells it to somebody else. Now, the realistic reason somebody would sell it to somebody else is because they're like, okay, the concerts were fun, but you know, I don't really care for them as much. Maybe I wanna trade into another person's NFT ecosystem. So I go, okay, I sell you a album or a song for $100. Not only do you get the song, you get that key, that access to come to those quarterly parties, for example, that are going to be created around you holding that key. The only way to get into the party is to scan your key, have your NFT, hold your ownership in your hand. It can't be faked. There's no tickets. There's no fake wristbands that people could print out. I've done it in college. We've tried to sneak into so many parties to the point where we had different wristbands. Depending on how we saw people's wristbands going into the party, we would figure out which wristband to put on to get into the party. Okay, so you can't do that anymore in Web3 when it comes to NFTs. So that's the cool part. Okay, so it really gives a true incentive and a true supply for the thing that you have to offer to your audience. That for the first time, we can add a definitive quantitative supply around what you create. Because with music right now, the reason it's so diluted is because any and everybody can have it right now. There's no quantifiable music. There's no technical supply. It's infinite. And you know supply and demand. If the supply is literally infinite, the demand would have to be infinite for your music to have intrinsic value to that degree. Okay, so the reason NFTs are so important is because it gives you digitized supply, meaning you can control the digital supply. Okay, so that's more on the business end. Let's go back to the access thing. So again, NFTs is not just the thing that you give somebody. It's the back end. Do you give them access to parties? Do you have a membership? Do you have a private Discord where you can reward people over time? Do they have access to talk to a private community? What is it that you offer on top of your music to make it extremely special for that person? Or is it just a collectible? It could just be a collectible. But the collectible stuff, the art bubble that you guys are hearing about with NFTs, it is a true bubble, because I mean, not everybody can pay $15,000. For CryptoPunk or a Mutated Ape or whatever they're called, your Bored Ape Yacht Club. Not everybody can do that. So that means that it's you have the masses and you have the affluent. So it's just not everybody's gonna be able to pay $15,000 for that. So collectibles, there is technically a bubble if there's no value behind it. We don't wanna get into deep economics because I'm not an economics guy, but I do wanna thank, man, here we go again. I want to thank the Instagram, here we go, third time's the charm, let's go. Oh my goodness, let's try this again. This is called Pattern Interrupt. I just interrupted your brain. You thought you knew my next words, but I tricked you. Okay, so I want to thank Metaverse with the 3 is the E on Instagram for this post by Chris Dixon, C Dixon on Twitter. And it goes through the different types of NFTs. There's art NFTs, music NFTs, access, game objects, redeemables, identity, Web2, and databases. So if NFTs are bigger than just art, they're bigger than music, but we're trying to make it simple. Okay, so again, let's go through those myths, make sure I covered everything because I kind of went on a side tangent and forgot. So again, when you're selling your NFT, you don't have to sell copyrights. When you're selling ownership, and the ownership has value, not just because I own a Drake song. That's not what people are talking about. It's I own a Drake song and now I have access to Drake's private parties that he throws every quarter. I own a Drake song, now I can get into this private Discord that nobody else has access to. I own a Drake song and now I'm identified as a certain status. That's the portion of ownership that makes sense. It's not just some fantasy thing, okay? Now, another myth is that NFTs are difficult. I will say it is difficult if you are going through the YouTube land trying to research NFTs, because the first thing people are gonna tell you, what's an NFT? A non-fungible token. You're like, what does that even mean? Even you telling me what NFT stands for doesn't make it make sense. That's why I'm here to make stuff simple. That's all I do. I've been doing this for a while. And we're gonna learn together, and I'm gonna share opportunities with you guys together. I have nothing to sell. I have nothing to promote, nothing, okay? So that means I'm gonna give you the absolute truth. This webcam is doing its own thing. Okay, I'm gonna give you the absolute truth when it comes to NFTs, because I too have felt the frustration of people making it extremely difficult, okay? So let's continue these myths real quick just to knock these objections out of your brain, because objections create fear, and when you have fear, you don't move forward. Okay, so also another myth about NFTs is that you have to sell them at high prices. Now, the reason this stuff is selling at high prices, like $15,000 for a picture, a JPEG that you can technically right click and save, but again, it's not about the picture. It's about the stuff that you get with the picture. It's about the status, the intangible status. It's about lording it over someone else. I have a $30,000 picture in my crypto wallet. You don't. I'm cooler than you. That's a value to some people. That's why Ferraris, Lamborghinis are valuable. That's why Gucci and luxury brands are valuable. That's why you flaunt your plugins over other people. It's because other people can't get it. That's why you like it. Okay? So another reason an intangible people get when it comes to, what was I talking about? Oh, the high prices, my apologies, my brain went on a tangent. I have gym brain, okay? Is when it comes to high priced things, let me read my notes because I am rambling, trying to figure out my thought. Oh, here's what I was gonna say. It's like Pokemon. So here's the thing. I know people say NFT and they say non-fungible token. To me, that makes zero sense. If you grew up like me in the 90s, you know about Pokemon. So for example, Forex is fungible, meaning money is fungible the way we understand it. If I give you a dollar, you can give me back a yen. You can give me however many yen a dollar equals, and it will be a somewhat even exchange, meaning I can trade it and trade it back very easily. Okay, that's what Forex is all about. I give you my dollar, I get back a euro. I give you a euro, I get back a yen. I give you a yen, I get back a peso. Okay, I don't know the other currencies out there. But when it comes to NFTs, it's like Pokemon cards. Okay, if I have a Charizard and you have a Porygon that's super rare, I think it's cool. So I'm gonna trade you a Charizard because I think in my head that Porygon's way cooler and I want your Porygon. Now the problem is Charizard has more liquidity because more people want the Charizard. It's more in demand. Whereas a Porygon, it's not the most favorite Pokemon out there. So I could trade you my Charizard for your Porygon. Okay, but that's cool. Now I have a Porygon. Now I'm holding on to Porygon because nobody else wants the Porygon. So now I'm holding on to it for 6 months, 12 months. That's an NFT. It's not as easily exchangeable as I can just go to somebody with euros and give them a dollar. I can go to somebody with pesos and give them a dollar. You can't really do that with NFTs. Now, there are solutions being created right now around creating liquidity for NFTs. But like I said, Web3 is so early that there's a lot of stuff that's, you know, technically possible, but we haven't created it yet. So for example, again, I have Charizard, you have a cool Porygon. I trade you my Charizard for your Porygon card. And now I'm stuck with Porygon because nobody in the market wants it. And now I'm just sitting for 6 months, sitting on a cool Porygon. It looks cool, but nobody wants it. And you are trading the Charizard for Blastoise. You got a Blastoise, you trade that for a Raichu. You get the Raichu, you trade it for a Pikachu. You get exactly what you want because a lot more people want the more mainstream things. The same way music. People know Drake. They might not know XXXTentacion even though he's big. RIP. They might not know a Juice WRLD even though he's big. They might not know a Knight Lavelle. They might not know, I'm trying to think of like an underground Denzel Curry. They might not know those type of folks. Whereas Drake, J. Cole, Kendrick. You can go to anybody in almost any culture, they'll probably know who Drake is. I mean, chances are they'll know who Drake is. And so that's the difference. You know, Drake is more liquid because more people know about him, whereas a Knight Lavelle, it's a really small niche, and it's going to be hard to trade a Knight Lavelle card for somebody who has a Drake card, for example, because they know it's harder to trade. So those are the things about music NFTs I want you to wrap your mind around. One is you don't have to sell your copyrights. Two is stop thinking of it as the thing. People are not really buying the thing. They're buying what comes with the thing. I own your music. I own your album. That gives me access to your private Discord. I own your music. I own your album. Now that means I get to go to your secret parties you have every 3 months. I own your music. I own your album. Now that means it gives me a certain status because I'm one of the 10 people who own it in the entire world. So that's the stuff that you're really selling. It allows you to gamify your audience. It allows you to create value that never existed before. Now, these are just the cool experimental things. I can tell you guys about the future. I can tell you guys about what if, just imagine for a second, what if you uploaded a song to the blockchain and it identified if somebody uploaded a copy to the blockchain? That means we would literally eradicate, to a degree, piracy or people sampling without your permission. Now, what if you could set it up to where, I'm just saying, what if, imagine this. Sorry, guys, my webcam is really bugging on me today. Come on, Betsy. All right, Betsy, listen. So what if you could upload a loop to a blockchain, for example, and then anybody who uploads a song with that loop, you get a royalty for it. I'm just saying, what if? These are the cool things with the blockchain. What if there's a watermark system? I'm just saying, what if? I don't think it exists just yet. But that's what SoundScan is, right? It understands and identifies the song. That's what it is. So what if you upload a song now, and now the people who sample your songs, you actually get royalties without getting screwed by your label, without getting screwed by accounting, without people not telling you they sampled you. And now it makes music rich again, because now we can account for stuff without it being such a headache. I can say, instead of going to these people to clear the record and do all this type of stuff, now copyright still exists. But I'm just saying, imagine a world where everybody could sample Drake if they wanted to. I'm just saying, imagine that type of world where we could sample anything at any time and all the money goes back to the righteous owner. That would be super dope. Again, there's a part of that that's copyright law, so there's still that hurdle. But when it comes to Web3, I just want you guys to think a lot bigger. Now, for us internet marketers who were in this for a while, we're used to getting paid right away. We're used to having our own distribution. We're used to controlling the marketing messages. But think about the average musician who goes into the system of the music industry. You go in, you have three companies, Sony, Warner, Universal, at the top of the pyramid. Okay? Those guys own all these subsidiary companies under them. All those subsidiary companies own you, the traditional musician and producer. You're at the bottom of a pyramid. T-Pain even has a video where he's like, you know, the average producer and artist get paid 13% or something around there. Of the 40 something billion, I forget the numbers in music now. It's either 20 or 40 billion. Either way, that's a lot of billions, okay? So you're only getting 15 to 20% of what you've created 100% of. That's like going to a bank, giving them $100, and they give you back $20 and say, have a good day. Insanity to me. But that's what people walk into with the traditional music industry. They give all of their ownership, they give all of their just due away. It just blows my mind. But that's what's happening on the average day in the traditional music industry. You walk in, you give them, oh my goodness, it's webcam, y'all. About to box them. Come on, Betsy. Come on, Betsy. Don't do me like that, Betsy. Come on, Betsy. Come on, Betsy. Okay, we're almost done. Okay, no more interruptions with this blurry web. What is causing the blur? Does it think I'm too tan? It thinks I'm the wall behind me? So to wrap this video, because we're almost at 20 minutes, is this. You get paid right away in the NFT world. There's no people blocking you from getting paid. There's no media trying to demonize you. We've heard what happened with Tory Lanez and him, you know, that media. I don't know the truth about it, but the fact that the media can twist the story to where people don't even support you anymore. And then you have companies that block your distribution because it's centralized. There's one company controlling who sells records. That's insane to me. Oh my goodness. It's a sign I need to wrap the video up. Okay, but just look at my blurry face. Okay, but just imagine a world where you get paid right away. Imagine a world where you don't get blocked by media people trying to demonize you and hold you back just because they don't like you. Imagine a world where You have direct communication with your audience. Imagine a world where people can't lie in contracts and be in their label's pocket and screw you over and be smiling, hey, you want to sign to this record label? I got your back. I'm a lawyer, but I really work for X, Y, and Z company. I'm not going to tell you that I work with them, but I'm really working with them. I get paid more from them than I do you. So I'm going to screw you technically in the contract, not tell you that I'm going to screw you, but I'm going to screw you in the contract and act like I'm your best friend. That happens all the time in music. It's basically what's happening is a purge of evil in music. I want you guys to be happy, hopeful, and excited because what's being built in Web3 is going to change everything. It's going to open up freedom. It's going to unlock that other 87% of wealth that you aren't accessing, okay? To think $40 billion is created every year and artists only get 13% of what they created is insane to me. I want you guys to get rich. I want you guys to provide for your family. I want you guys to change the world for positive. I want you guys to go out there and show love. I want you guys to go out there and live your abundant mission and your assignment. That's what we're here to do. We're here to transform lives. Music is like a spirit. I create a song and it goes into your body and it makes you think things and it makes you do things based on if you're inspired or motivated or influenced. That's music. We are using it to change the world for positivity. It's to get you so happy with music that you can commune with the creator. That's the purpose of music. So let us take music back from the evil hands that have it. Let's take it back from the demonic forces that are trying to control it. And let's put it into prosperity. Let's put it into abundance in the immutable blockchain. This is a religion. I'm just teasing, guys. So thank you. Subscribe if you're new. We're going to have a lot more NFT talks. Oh, also, I want you guys to check out mintbase.io. Excuse me. Okay, so I'm going to switch the screen real quick. I want you guys to check this website out. And Deadmau5 just made a drop on this website. How do I switch? Okay, Deadmau5 just did a drop on this website. I think he sold like 500,000 copies, something insane. Shout out to Deadmau5. I used to be on Razor Music campaigns for 2 years, and we were both on the same campaign on Razor Music. Me, Deadmau5, Metro, Murder Beats, pardon me, Sunny Digital. Who else was on that? I'm forgetting the other folks, but shout out to them too. So come to mintbase.io. This is the company we're going to rock with. This is a Near. They're based on the Near platform. We're going to rock with Near, period. Okay, they're showing the most love and showing the most honesty to me. And it's affordable and all this stuff. So I want you guys to investigate mintbase.io, okay? And let's start a revolution here. I want you guys to get your just due. I want you guys to live, okay? Transform lives. Let's go. Thank you. Subscribe if you're new. Like the video, share with your friends to give them a really simple explanation about NFTs. It's not that complicated. It's that people want to make it complicated so that they sell you the solution on how to make it easy. I'm not here to be doing nothing like that. Thank you guys. Peace.